Hello students, today we are going to start new unit and that is unit number 7 in which we will start today new chapter, chapter number 5, Principles of Inheritance and Variations. Okay, and today we are going to discuss about introduction of this chapter. So before we start the chapter, let me go through one analysis and that is last 10 year NEET analysis from 2009 to 2019. Okay, that is from chapter number 5 and here you can see list of topics which you will learn in this chapter. Okay, let me start from the first topic, Mendel's law of inheritance. You can see here from this particular topic, total 16 questions were asked in last 10 years. Okay, second topic is the inheritance of one gene, that is a monohybrid cross. Okay, and from that you can see here 41 questions were asked in last 10 years. Okay, then next is the incomplete dominance, 12 questions were asked from that. Co-dominance, 15 questions were asked from that. Then inheritance of two genes, that is a dihybrid cross, from that you can see 18 questions were asked. Okay, then multiple alleles and pleiotropism, 17 questions were asked. Okay, and 4 questions were asked from epitelsis, complementary genes, supplementary genes. Okay, and 5 questions were asked from chromosomal theory of inheritance. Okay, then here you can see 20 questions were asked from this topic, linkage and recombination. Okay, and then 22 questions were asked from sex determination. Okay, and 21 questions were asked from mutation, from pedigree analysis. Total 21 questions were asked. Okay, sorry, 8 questions were asked. Genetic disorder, from genetic disorder topic, total 56 questions were asked. So here from these analysis you can get the idea which topic is most important. Before we start the chapter, we will go through some terminologies which is very important to learn this chapter. Okay, let me start with the first terminology and that is genetics. Okay, genetics is the term which is used whenever a study of inheritance or a heredity or a variation of a character. Okay, so genetics is the study of inheritance, hereditary variation of a character, or maybe it is used for the study of genes or chromosomes. So whenever person study about the inheritance, hereditary variation, study of genes, chromosome, then you can use the term genetics. That is a one kind of a study. Then second term is a inheritance. What is the meaning of inheritance? It is the transmission of a character from parents to progeny. Okay, means from the offspring, means from parents to offspring. Okay, and it is the basis of heredity. So this inheritance terminology use, it is indicating, what it is indicating? It is the transmission of a characters from parent to progeny or offspring. Okay, it is basis of a hereditary. Now next terminology which is used during this chapter will be a variation. Okay, so what is a variation? It is the differences between parents and offsprings in terms of characters. You know very well, parents and offspring both are different from each other, even they have same genetic composition. Okay, mostly same genetic composition is there, but though they will show some characteristic differences. Okay, some characteristic will be from mother, some character will be from the father. Okay, so such differences between parents and offspring in terms of characters is called variation. Then next is a character. Okay, so a heritable feature. Okay, there is a heritable feature among the parents and the offspring. Suppose we are looking at here this diagram. This is the eye color. This eye color is considered as a brown, yes, emerald, then blue, gray. These all are the characters. Okay, these traits are indicating the character. Okay, and it is a heritable feature among the parents and offspring. It can be heritable, means from parents it will transmit to the offspring. Okay, and next is a trait. When trait, this term is utilized, it is a variance of character. Suppose eye color is one character, right? Okay, so eye color is a one character, and here some options are there. Means so many options are available for eye color, whether it is brown, emerald, then blue, gray. Okay, these all are options from the eye color. Eye color itself is a character. Okay, whereas the options available for the eye color is considered as a traits. Okay, so be very clear what is a character and what is a trait. Okay, so here variants of the character. means options available for the character, particular character, and that is called trait. Here you can see brown color eye, blue color eye, emerald color eye, like that. Okay, so these all terminologies are widely utilized during this chapter. Next important terminology is alleles, and that is also considered as allelomorphs. Okay, so that is the alternative form of a genes. Here you can say this is the chromosome on which you can see here one band is there, that is purple color band, and that is responsible for the genetical composition. Okay, and this particular region which is indicated as a capital B is considered as a gene present on the chromosome. Okay, so alternative forms of the genes is considered as alleles. Okay, for example, a tool for the character tool, T is indicated, and for the dwarfness, small t is there, or both are the alleles of the gene for the character of a height. Okay, suppose height is indicated as a tall, then it is indicating as a T. That is one kind of allele which is responsible for the tall height. Okay, and second is a small t, that is responsible for dwarf height. And these both are options, okay, or forms, alternative forms of genes. Okay, and such an alternative form of gene is considered as alleles, and that is also considered as allelomorphs. Okay, and then next terminology, very important terminology it is, and that is called homozygous. What is the meaning of homozygous? Let me understand with this diagram. Here you can see chromosomes on which particular gene is present on specific location. Okay, here you can see this purplish color band present on both the chromosome, and both are indicated as a capital B. Okay, means both are responsible for transferring same character, and such a condition is considered as a homozygous. Okay, such a condition is called homozygous. Here is also homozygous. Okay, here both are different, so that is not homozygous, it is called heterozygous. That is the next terminology. And here you can see both are small b and b. Okay, both having small bb, that's why this also having homozygous condition. Okay, so what is a homozygous condition? It is the condition in which chromosome pair carries, here one pair of a chromosome is there, both the pair means both condition having similar alleles. Here you can see this is one allele, this is second allele, and both are same. Okay, and same similar allele of a gene, and also none is a pure line. Okay, this is also condition termed as a pure line or a true breeding. Okay, for example, here you can see capital TT, small TT, capital YY, or a small YY. Okay, so these all condition, if both the chromosome having similar kind of genes on that, that condition is called homozygous condition. Okay, whether it is small bb or a capital bb. Now next terminology, that is also very important terminology, and it is called heterozygous. Okay, so what is the meaning of heterozygous? Here, the condition in which chromosome pair carries dissimilar alleles. Here you can see the example. Okay, this is a pair of a chromosome. On the one chromosome there is a capital B, on another chromosome there is a small b. That means both genes are different from each other. Okay, and that's why this is called heterozygous in condition. Okay, so the condition in which chromosome pair carries dissimilar alleles of a gene, for example, capital T, one is a capital T, second is a small t, capital Y, small y, like this. Okay, so this both terminology, homozygous as well as heterozygous, both terminology will be frequently used during this chapter. Next important terminology is a dominant character. The character which is expressed in a heterozygous condition is called dominant character. Okay, it is indicated as a capital letter always. Okay, next one is a recessive character, that is the character which is suppressed. Okay, it means not expressed. Okay, so whatever the expressed is considered as dominant character, whereas whatever not expressed is considered as a suppressed type of character. Okay, so the character which is suppressed in heterozygous condition, and it is indicated with the small letter. And here you can see some list of example of a dominant character, and similarly here a list of a recessive character. So these will be expressed and this will be suppressed. Okay, and phenotype. Next terminology is the phenotype. So what is a phenotype? This terminology which is used during a physical expression of a character. Okay, so when you want to express about the physical expression of a character, okay, which we can observe, okay, and such a expression of a character is considered as a phenotype. Okay, and next is a genotype, a genetic constitution of a character. Suppose one character is expressed in the person, okay, what is the genetical makeup or what is the genetical constitution of that person is considered as a genotype. Okay, and next one is a hybrid. So what is the meaning of a hybrid? It is an individual produced by mating of a genetically unlike parent, means different parents. Okay, from we are selecting two different parents, we hybridize in between them. Okay, and as a result of that, whatever the offspring is obtained is called hybrid. An individual which is produced by mating of a genetically unlike, means different parents. Here in this slide, you can see photograph of a very well-known scientist, Gregor Mendel. Okay, and he is considered as a father of genetics. In next slide, let me understand why he is considered as a father of genetics. So now let me go through some contribution of Gregor Mendel, and here you can see a lifespan of Gregor Mendel is 1822 to 1884. Okay, so during 1864, Mendel published the result of his experiment with garden pea, and that is Pisum sativum. Okay, in which he crossed parents and examined offspring become the father of genetics. Just because of the experiment carried out by the Mendel, not only for that, but he had concluded some laws of genetics, and that's why he had considered as a father of genetics. Okay, and he had concluded that parents contribute particles, that nowadays it is called as genes. Okay, so parents will contribute particle, that is nowadays called genes or a genetic unit, to their offspring. That he was the first scientist to contribute this one. Okay, and that's why he is considered as a father of genetics. The particulate nature of inheritance and laws of inheritance, a final pieces in the puzzle that fulfilled Darwin's vision of evolution. So this Darwin vision of evolution by natural selection we will learn in detail in chapter number 7, and how these Mendel's laws are important to solve this theory we will learn in detail in next lectures. Okay, and Mendel's contribution, this is very unfortunate to the world. Okay, so Mendel's contribution did not become none. Okay, so you can understand this is very unfortunate to the world that Mendel's contribution did not become none until early in the 20th century, means after that of the Mendel. So now let me go through some reasons why Mendel's work was unrecognized by the world. Okay, and it was recognized only after his death. Okay, let me go some reason. So why Mendel's work went unrecognized? Because however the great significance of Mendel's discovery, okay, this is very unfortunately, means unfortunately his work was recognized only after his death. Okay, so even great significance of Mendel's discovery was not appreciated by contemporary biologists. And why? Because of this, his work was ahead of his time. Okay, he was very modern, and that's why his work was ahead of his time. That's why nobody can understand his work at that time. He published it in a journal that had limited circulation. Okay, he cannot publish his work or publicity, he cannot do the publicity. Okay, and that's why his journal is very limited circulation. So some people can got the limited journals, and that's why some people get the idea what Mendel is doing. Okay, he was himself not sure of his finding, as he failed to get similar result on hawkweed, that is one plant. Okay, and his mathematical approach in the biology, mathematical approach was very new to the world. Okay, means nobody understand how we can use the mathematical tools in the biology. So Mendel was the first scientist who had utilized the mathematical and statistical analysis in the biology, and that's why the similar colleagues of his scientists, okay, cannot understand his work. His mathematical approach in the working out biological problems was strange. Okay, nobody can understand. Okay, we can utilize mathematics in the biology at that time for then scientists. And the second thing, mind of the biologist was preoccupied with the Darwin's theory of evolution. We will learn in detail what is the Darwin's theory in evolution in chapter number 7. Okay, that's why some people are following Darwin's rules and Darwin's theory of evolution. That's why nobody can occupy, means nobody can understand work of Mendel. So let me go through what was done by the Mendel. So Mendel had conducted some hybridization experiment on garden peas, and this garden pea, particularly scientific name for this garden pea is a Pisum sativum. And he had conducted this whole experiment for the 7 years, from 1856 to 1860. Mendel had done all the experiment on garden pea, that is Pisum sativum. Now let me understand why Mendel has selected garden pea for his experiment. Okay, there are some reasons to selecting the garden pace. What are the reason? Let me discuss. So first reason is it has a number of well-defined contrasting character. Means they have a contrasting character. We will learn what are the contrasting character present in the garden pea. Okay, that's why he had selected this garden pea. Then second one, it has a bisexual flower. Means male and female both type of structures are present in same flower. Bisexual flowers are present. It shows predominantly self-fertilization. Okay, that is autogamy. Thus pure breed are easily available in these plants. Then second one, fourth one, hybridization or a crossing is easy in the pea plant, and that's why he had selected. And it has a short lifespan. Okay, this garden pea has a short lifespan, thus greater number of generation can be studied in a short period. So these are the list of reasons why Mendel had selected garden pea and experimented on that. Okay, this question may be asked in 2 marks in the board's examination. Here in this slide you can see steps of experiment which is carried out by the Mendel during his experiment. Okay, let me discuss about that. The first step during the experiment was carried out by Mendel was the selection. Okay, he had selected 2 pea plants. Here you can see pea plant was selected for having a contrasting character. Okay, he had selected plant with this 2 pea plant as a parent plant. Okay, with having contrasting characters. Then what he had done? He had done emasculation process. What is the meaning of emasculation? Here in this diagram you can see. Okay, this is the flower. Okay, this is the female flower and this is male flower. Okay, you can see here anther are removed, so it become female flower. Okay, generally it is bisexual flower, pea plant having a bisexual flower, but he had removed this anther surgically. Here you can see by using this scissor. Okay, and that's why this flower now become female flower, because only gynoecium will remain in the flower. Okay, anther part will be removed. Okay, that's why this become artificially female flower, and then these anther will be utilized for the fertilization event of this flower. Okay, and this process is called emasculation. That means removal of anthers of one plant, okay, to avoid self-pollination, and this is now become female flower parent or a female flower artificially. Third step was a pollination. Okay, collection of a pollen grain from the male parent. Suppose this will consider as a male parent. Okay, so here from the anther, this pollen grain will be collected and it will be sprinkled on this stigma of this flower, which will artificially become female flower. Okay, so pollination, collection of a pollen grain from the male parent and transferring to the female parent. Okay, and the next step is and the last step is the collection and the germination of a seeds to produce offspring, and as a result of this you can see these plants will be available. Here in this slide you can see contrasting traits, a list of a contrasting trait which is found in the Pisum sativum plant. Okay, and these may be asked in 2 marks, so you have to remember each contrasting trait. Okay, which one is a dominant and which one is a recessive. Okay, so here you can see a character, a list of a character in which you can observe a dominant character and recessive one. Okay, that's why only the Pisum sativum was selected by the Mendel. Okay, because of just contrasting traits. Okay, so 7 breeding varieties selected by the Mendel. These all are 7 character which are selected by the Mendel. Okay, and you have to remember each character and having contrasting trait with the dominant and recessive. Okay, so here let me discuss. First character is a stem height. First dominant character is a tall. Okay, and this one is recessive, one is a dwarf. So what is a dominant character and what is a recessive character? You know very well, as I told you in the definition. So let me repeat first. So what is a dominant character? So if tall related gene and recessive related gene is present in same cell, then only dominant will be expressed. And these will remain in the cell, but it will remain unexpressed or suppressed. Okay, so tall and dwarf, out of these two, only tall will be expressed if this allele is present. Okay, flower position axial is a dominant one, terminal is a recessive one, in flower color is a violet and white. What is meant? Means violet color related gene is present, in if it is present, then white color gene will be suppressed. Okay, only violet will be expressed. Pore shape, inflated, constricted. Here you can see tall and dwarf, axial and terminal, then violet color flower, white color flower. This is full type of pore shape, okay, inflated. Then constricted type of pore shape. Then pore color is a green and yellow. Here you can see pore color is a green and yellow. Okay, then seed shape is a round is a dominant one and wrinkle is a recessive one. So here you can see this round is a dominant one and wrinkle is a recessive one. Then seed color is a yellow. Yellow is a dominant. This yellow color seed is a dominant one. Okay, whereas this green color is a recessive one. So in presence of yellow color gene, this green color gene will be suppressed. Only yellow color gene will be expressed. So by this way, you can say this all seven having a contrasting trait, and that's why these traits are selected by the Mendel. Now let me discuss about reasons for Mendel's success. Okay, why Mendel's experiment was successfully carried out? Let me see the reason. He had used an experimental approach, that is a scientific method, and that's why he was successful. Okay, and applied mathematics to the study of a natural phenomena. Okay, that is a ratios and probability, that is considered as a statistical analysis. Okay, and kept good records. This is very important in any scientific research. Okay, to give good records should be kept. Okay, and observations and large test sample or a size. Okay, this is also very important step. Large test sample or a size. This is very important for the convincing the world about the experiment. And he had done these all, and that's why he was successfully doing. This is your homework for today's lecture. And before we finish this lecture, let me summarize whole topic by using one animation video. So look at this video.
Gregor Johann Mendel played a vital role in discovering the laws of heredity. He carried out several hybridization experiments with true breeding felines, which had sharply contrasting characters. One such experiment was the crossing of a tall and a dwarf pea plant. Since the cross was between plants that differed in a single trait, that is, height. In this case, Mendel called it a monohybrid cross. Furthermore, Mendel called the tall and the dwarf plants in this experiment the parental or the pea generation. After the cross between the tall and dwarf plants, Mendel collected the seeds and planted them to produce the first hybrid called the F1 generation, or the first filial of plants. He found that all the plants in the F1 generation were always tall, like one of the parents, and the dwarfness had disappeared. Mendel conducted similar experiments with other pairs of traits and made certain observations. Every single time, he found that the F1 hybrid resembled only one of the parents, while the other parent's trait was missing. To explore this further, Mendel self-pollinated the F1 hybrids to produce a second hybrid generation of plants, known as the F2 generation, or second filial of plants. Interestingly, this time, the progeny included both tall and dwarf plants in a definite ratio. 3/4 of the plants in the F2 hybrid were tall, while 1/4 was dwarf. Mendel also noticed that the plants did not show blending or mixing. That is, none of them were of in-between height. Once again, to confirm his observations, Mendel conducted experiments with other traits. His results were confirmed when he found that both the parental traits were expressed in the F2 hybrid in the proportion 3:1. Moreover, the contrasting traits did not show any blending in either the F1 or F2 stages. From his experiments, Mendel inferred that something was being stably passed on from parents to progeny over successive generations. This was the reason the dwarfness that had disappeared in the F1 hybrid had reappeared in the F2 hybrid. Mendel called this something factors, which are known as genes today. Genes are represented by letters for our convenience. The trait expressed in the F1 hybrid is denoted by a capital letter, while the other trait is denoted by a small letter. As all plants obtained in the cross between tall and dwarf plants were tall in the F1 hybrid, the tall trait is denoted by capital T and the dwarf by small t. Here, capital T and small t are alleles of each other. That is, they are a pair of genes representing two alternative forms of the same character, namely the height of the plant. Therefore, pairs of alleles for height in plants would be capital T capital T, capital T small t, and small t small t. Here, capital T capital T, capital T small t, and small t are genotypes of the plant, and the descriptive terms tall and dwarf are the phenotypes. The alleles in the genotype capital T capital T and small t are similar or homozygous, while the alleles in the genotype capital T small t are dissimilar or heterozygous. Moreover, Mendel also called the character that expresses itself in the F1 hybrid dominant, and the one that failed to express itself, recessive.
In next lecture, we will learn about Mendel's monohybrid cross experiment. And till then, goodbye.